Hello and welcome. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. And in this quick optics tutorial, we're going to be taking a focus on the light filter. And I'll be showing you how we can create soft dappled looks or add a simple or more complex gobo effect to your shot. The light filter is found in the light category. And if we apply this effect to our image here, we can start to see what it's doing. So at its default, it's creating a soft light gobo effect. And if we take a look at the presets, we can choose which of the many different shapes we can use or we might want to use on a particular image. And if I go up to the top here, we can sort these out by abstract or certain doors, windows, textures, or things like foliage for casting a nice dappled shadow or shade across your image. And I'm going to come up here and search water. I'll use one of the caustics ones here. In fact, I'll use water droplets so we can see this quite nice and clearly. So once we've chosen our shape in the presets, I'm going to come into the parameters tab and we can start to work with some of our parameters. Now, the most useful ones that we're going to use are going to be things like how we're blending these together using the add mode, screen blend mode, or subtract. Here I'll keep this at add. We can change the brightness to get a more pronounced effect, and we can even use displacement to displace our light around or across our image. So now if I move this along here, you can see like it's following along the contours of her face. Displacement is really useful for getting a more natural looking effect. We can also blur this up as well, get a more soft, subtle look. I'll keep that shading at default, just reset that there. And I'm going to skip over shadow and gobo and come straight down to transform, because this is the other one that we're going to be using quite a lot. So I can scale everything up. If I don't want to scale horizontally and vertically the same, I can turn off gang. And now I have controls over how I scale those individually. Let's take a look at the before and the after. So let's use light now to create a bit of drama. So as before, I'm going to find the right preset for myself and I'm going to come to something a bit ornate. Ornate 3, yeah, I like the look of that. And let's come into parameters and let's change the brightness up a little bit and change the blur down so it's a bit sharper so we can see this a bit clearer. Now in the view, you've seen me move this around just using the center point. And in the previous shot, we used the transform to scale things up and down. But we have even finer controls available to us. If you take a look at the four corners here, I can use these four corners as corner pins to distort the image in how I want it to be. So maybe let's bring this, these both over here. Let's get a nice dramatic looking image. I'm holding down the space bar so I can pan around a little bit here. And let's get that over somewhere there. And once I've got my distortion into place, I can still come in and just use the center point to move it around where I want it to go or scale it up and down as necessary. And I'm going to take the blur all the way down to zero because I want to show you some of the other controls and it's a bit easier to see when everything's nice and clear. Now we can colorize our gobo either using some of the drop downs here with our Lee filter coded gels. Set that there, or of course I can choose my color just by sampling it here. I'll undo that, and that brings us down to the shadow controls. So up till now we've been using the brightness to change how the image starts to look. Now if I come to shadow and start bringing that up, that starts to make the rest of the image a little bit darker, making our light gobo a bit more pronounced. When it comes to blending the gobo, we can come into the gobo controls. Well, I can choose a custom image for my gobo by clicking on browse or change how the blending mode works with this gobo. So if I set this to something like multiply instead or darken or add, we're getting a different look to the image. So by changing the blend mode, we're not just blending in the gobo back over the top, we're also using some of the image and blending that back in as well. and that's being affected by the mat that's just opened up down at the bottom. So we look at the view, we can check out what the gobo looks like, we can check out what the mat looks like, and we can choose to base this on the highlights or the shadows. Bring that in there. And we have the channel key available that you might be familiar with if you've worked with the selection mask. It's the same basic idea. Let's look at the output on this one. And we come back into the gobo controls. I can change the opacity of how that's mixing back and forward. And I can also change the blur on the gobo here. So check out the difference between blur up at the top with the light. That blurs my light outwards. So that's a 7-point blur gives us that effect. I'm going to take a snapshot of it. And let's see what a 7-point blur does on the gobo. Let's compare the two. Let's bring the blur on the gobo up a little bit more. You can see that's just softening the shadows whilst keeping our edges a bit sharper. And I really like this effect. And I'll tweak up just a couple of the parameters here. Add a quick spot mask to add a bit of fall off to it. And let's check out the quick before and after. And I think that's adding a bit of drama to the shot. I like that. Let's finish off with one more shot and show you how we can blend multiple versions of the light effect together. And I'm going to come down and search to find some stripes. And here we go, shutters 11. It's looking quite nice. So let's come in, let's position this actually somewhere in the middle. And we'll come down and we'll scale this up a little bit. And we'll scale the vertical. So we're getting a lot of hard strokes there. There we go. And we'll turn our blur down. I'll probably put that just to one for now. And change the displacement up. So we're displacing around the face or across the face. And with that displacement, I probably want to tap the blur up just a little bit more as well. And bring the brightness down. So we're getting a slightly more subtle effect. So we've got the light stripes bending around the contours of our model here. But unfortunately, the displacement, because of the way it works, is also displacing around the background as well. And I don't like that. I don't want that. So what I'm going to do is create a mask just on our girl. And probably the easiest one for this one to do is using our easy mask because we have nice fine hair details. If you want to learn more about easy mask, then check out our main easy mask tutorial. But it breaks down to basically defining what the foreground is, defining what the background is, and then letting easy mask do the hard work for us. So now I've got the light just going over our model here. I'm going to create a new layer. And I'm going to drag my light up to duplicate it. I'm going to drag my mask up to duplicate that. And I'm just going to come in, select the mask and invert that. So now I can come back into the main effect, come into my parameters and turn that displacement off, turn that back down to zero. So now I've got straight lines on the background and I've got displaced lines going over our girl. And I can even rename these effects. Light background and light model. So now I have complete control over these separately and I can come in and maybe add a little bit more brightness to the background, possibly blur the background up a little bit more just to put that, just to make that sit back a little bit and give a little bit more focus to our main subject. Then if I select the edit button, I can now come in and change the editing or edit how I'm working with our light just on the main model. So I could play around with this a little bit more, but I think you get the idea. And we'll have a look at the before and after. Before, after, before, and after. Now, obviously, that's just a brief look at what you can start to create with the light effect. Like all of the optics filters, this is a great one to start just playing around with, working with the presets to see what you can do. And then just fine-tuning the effect in the parameters so that it fits your image exactly how you want it to. Thanks for now. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris FX, and I'll see you again in another optics tutorial soon. Thanks for watching. To learn more about optics and to download a free trial, then head on over to borisfx.com. You'll also find the latest news, events, and a host of other tutorials for all with Boris FX products. Thanks for watching.